na mana I na te iwi e te motu tēnā koutou katoa. Can I just acknowledge Ray and the work that he does on behalf of children in New Zealand, really, and the way he leads that organisation, and how he's championed this initiative, to be honest. It's something he started talking to me about right from day one. And so I just want to acknowledge the work you and your team are doing, and I know that as I go around the country, that focus goes right through child, youth and family, and it's something that should be attributed to your leadership at a big level. Peter, thank you for being here. To John Angus, who I see here, Judge Bosher, I think is here, there he is. So many others that I see, it's great to have you here, thank you for coming out today. Today I am announcing an important initiative that endeavours to help some very important New Zealanders. They are the children in care, who don't have a permanent home to go to, and the people who have the space in their hearts to welcome a child into their home and make them part of their family. Thousands of New Zealand children grow up under the care of the state. As Ray said, they've been removed from their homes out of necessity because it's generally not safe for them to be there. Thankfully, we have thousands of foster parents in this country doing an outstanding job, trying to care for children who have nowhere else to go. And there are some children living in child, youth and family residences because it's the only option left. We know this isn't a good way for a child to start their lives. We know that children need a stable, loving home where they're cared for and can feel they belong. So the government's put together a package to encourage New Zealanders with the heart, the courage and the generosity needed to step in and provide that home for life. At any one time, there are around 5,500 children in the custody of child, youth and family. Many live in child, youth and family residences and group homes. The remaining 4,300 in out-of-home placements. That means they're staying with extended whānau or with foster carers. For children in care, there is no certainty, no permanency, and no stability. They literally do not have a permanent home or permanent family to belong to. It's understandably difficult for most people to imagine what that's like. It's hard enough to believe hundreds of children are born into families every year who cannot or will not look after them. Children born into a life without that love and without care. In these cases, child, youth and family must step in and find a new home that will keep that child safe. But often these are temporary solutions and provide no real ongoing security for that child. Half of the children in child, youth and family care have been there for more than 2 years. Yeah, you saw it there, more than 2 years. And if you think about being 4 or 5 years old, that's more than half of your lifetime. At the moment, there are more than 300 kids under 5 who've been in care for 2 years or more. Over 600 kids have spent more than 4.5 years in care. And actually some never leave. 8% of children who come into state care are there until they're 18 and leave because they're old enough to go and live independently. Most drift from one home to another. Some can live in as many as 10 different foster homes. At least 20% have lived in 5 or more different foster homes. And it goes without saying that this is an incredibly difficult childhood experience for them. Remember too, these children are so often victims of violence and abuse and neglect, who have seen and experienced things that have affected them deeply. Sometimes as a result of these experiences, they have physical and mental issues, which further challenge them and those that care for them. But every child in New Zealand deserves a loving, stable home. So today, we're announcing Home for Life. This is a package aimed at encouraging families to take a child on permanently, giving that child the stability, the permanence and the security most of us take for granted. When I first heard Home for Life sort of being raised by Ray, I must admit that as a mother of early 20s, I thought, oh, does that mean I've got it for life? And sort of saw the humorous side of that, as anyone that has an older teenager fears that they're going to keep on moving back home once they've moved out. And then I thought, wouldn't it be great if these kids had that? You know, that when they hit their early 20s and they've moved away, that actually they had a bed that they knew they could go back to someday. Whereas we as parents make light of it, but actually isn't that security a fantastic thing that my daughter and some of your children have? That if the wheels get a little bit wobbly, Mum will take them back in and do what we need to do. So I hope that for these kids, quite frankly. So there are just over 2,000 foster carers currently, many of whom want to take a child on permanently, but are concerned about losing state support and being left to cope alone. This package is designed to make it easy to offer a child permanence and clearly sets out the ongoing support the child, youth and family will offer. We want New Zealanders to know if they take on a child permanently, child, youth and family will be there to provide help and support when it's needed or if the going gets a bit bumpy. So, the package includes an upfront payment of $2,500 to contribute to costs like school uniforms, sports, clothing, etc. A baby care starter pack. This will help families with buying a cot, push chairs, high chairs, bottles and baby wear in those early years that can help them get started. Reasonable legal costs to go through that court process of permanency. So working alongside that social worker, you'll have an understanding of what that legal process is, we'll know up front what the costs are going to be, and Child, Youth and Family will cover that and also work through the process with them. Assistance with mediation and contact with birth parents as needed. Yeah? A respite care for families who need some time out. This is still one of my things. I still think that no matter where you're at, you sometimes need a wee break, and it can be harder to have it if you haven't got that extended family related to that time. So respite care with those children's health camps that do such a fantastic job is a real opportunity for them. Ongoing support with other agencies like Barnardo's, Open Home Foundation, both of whom are here, thank you so much. And others. This could be help with parenting or advice on dealing with birth parents or counselling for those children or even a bit of counselling for yourself sometimes if you're working with children who can be a little more troubled. A child, youth and family dedicated phone line for carers who can call and get priority service when they need help or advice. We'll also check on families after 3 months to see if they need any more support, and again after 6 months. Child, youth and family seminars will provide information for carers, and Child, Youth and Family will ensure they're getting the correct entitlements from work and income, and that will be ongoing. All of these things are designed to help carers take the steps to provide home for life. We expect these measures to reduce the length of time children are in state care and reduce the number of kids in care by 1,200 over 4 or 5 years. There's an urgent need to do this for the children in care because the benefits to them are obvious. But there's also another group of people for whom this will be welcome. All those carers who desperately love the child or children in their care but don't know if they can quite take that next step towards permanency. They've told us they're scared of they'll lose allowances and financial support they get now, and that they'll be on their own if they hit a bump in the road. So they take them on permanently, and at the moment we do our bit, but really we withdraw and leave them to it. And if they need help in a year's time when things are just starting to brew up a little bit, we can step back in and help with some counselling. We'd rather be doing it now than stepping in and doing that. 0508 carers, they can call and there will be someone at the end of the phone that can actually provide that advice and work with them then, instead of seeing it escalate to a point where we perhaps have to deal with a more dramatic sort of incident. So it sort of made sense to us to put some of these measures in place that give people security. A big part for me as well with this was that we did it at the request of those parents. Yeah, so those parents that have taken these children on in permanency, they get to sort of dictate how much we're there or not. So So there are some that can't wait to get us out of their lives. That would be fair to say. There are some that like, give me that child, thank you very much, child, youth and family, see you around. And then there are others that are a little bit like, yeah, wouldn't mind you walking alongside of us for a bit longer, or wouldn't mind being able to pick up the phone, call you, get extra assistance, get some help with some of the things around it. And as always happens in my life, if you like, you meet great people that share their stories with you. And there was one quite very recently that quite struck me. So she's a woman in her late 20s who I see quite often in my working relationship. Yeah, so I just see her from time to time, probably seen her a dozen times this year to have a conversation with her, how's it going, and this sort of thing. And I was chatting to her the other day about some of the fostering, and she turned around and she said, I was a foster kid. Yeah, and I thought, well, I didn't know that, never thought. She said, at 5 years old, I was taken on permanently. And my mum, yeah, at 5 years old, turned around and said to everyone, no one will lie to this child again. No one will ever let you down. No one will be 5 minutes late when they say they're going to pick her up. No one will not turn up to something when they say they will. Because I said to her, how did it work? How have you turned to where you are now with some pretty big adversaries against you? You know, some stuff that's sort of clouding in there. And some kids don't actually get to their late 20s and are as successful as you do. And she said it was that mum standing up for her and being her mum. And she said, I knew she had my back no matter what. And she said it took her 3 years to trust her. 3 years to really believe that she wasn't going to leave her, you know, wasn't going to be someone, another adult that lied to her, another adult that let her down, another adult that went, well, this has been fun. And she said, I tested her, you know. A couple of years and I gave it everything I could because I thought, this can't be this good. And she said, you know, it was such a profound time in her life that she remembers it really well. And I just, don't you just wish that for all of those children? And I think that if we can do our bit that steps up and makes that an easier process, that acknowledges there are some costs to it, that acknowledges there are some complexities to it as you work your way through the system, then I think that actually removing some of those barriers can mean better results for those kids. So we're saying you won't be alone, you know? If you need help, it's there and we will back you. The package means the financial support is there, child, youth and family are there, for as long as necessary. And that can be ongoing for that child's lifetime. This package makes it possible for those incredibly generous Kiwis to welcome a child into their home for life. As I said before, over 600 children had been in care for 4.5 years. Of those, 100 have been in the same placement that whole time. For those carers in those situations, a home for life may be that natural next step. And if there is anything holding them back, this initiative, we hope, opens that door. And that door is open to anyone who thinks they can provide a stable, caring home for a child permanently. Talk to us. It's imperative we do everything possible to provide a different pathway for these young and very deserving New Zealanders. We owe it to them, and we owe it to New Zealand. Thank you.